Welcome back to another 12 Days of Anime Boiling Edition. And I'm so actually really excited for what we're going to be talking about today's video. Because as I mentioned previously, I think it was in my free video for day three, there was going to be two studios that I was going to mention that I love. I've already mentioned Kyoto Animation. And another one that I absolutely fall in love with this studio's work, which is PA Works. And I'm already watching right now The World of Colors that's currently airing in the fall 2018 season, which has been, oh my goodness, feels. A series that came out in the summer 2018 season, which I was debating if I was going to talk about it in a video or was, but you know, I thought, you know what? Nah, gotta do it, and I believe it's now on Netflix. And a new series that came out, which was a vampire series I talked about yesterday. As a hint, yes, it's the vampire genre that I have the guilty pleasure for. Whether it's been vampire trash like Diabolic Lovers, or it's been scary Shiki, I'm there. You recommend me a vampire series, I'm good to go. And they brought out, surprisingly, Sirius the Jaeger. Sirius the Jaeger is set in the 1930s in the Imperial Capital, and a group of vampire hunters known as the Jaegers have come after the vampires who are seeking a certain item known as the Ark of Sirius, which belongs to a heritage of one of the Jaeger hunters known as Yuli. He is actually a werewolf. And Yuli's sole purpose is he wants to kill every vampire there is in sight, because vampires killed his entire family and his whole village, known as Dog Village. And it's pretty basic synopsis, you know, vampire hunters going after the vampires, which in this series, the vampires are called the Royals. Sirius the Jaeger has so many like ums and ahs for me, but in general, if I had to say if I enjoyed it, I did enjoy it. It was definitely entertaining, but there's a lot of, you know, hit and misses with this series, but I'll be going through the good and not really the bad points, just the things that missed the mark. But first up, what I absolutely loved about this series, well, it's the animation, obviously. Like, I think PA Works really knocked it out of the park this time. Just the detail of the world, you know, set in the 1930s, that's a time where, based on real history, where there was, you know, the Great Depression, the economy was slowing down, it wasn't doing so well then, and I really think they captured the classic authentic look of this time era. Everything just looked absolutely fantastic, especially in the night landscape scenes. Animation was just top notch. Especially I loved all the characters' anime eyes, they just glowed, especially Yuli's beautiful blue ice eyes. And also the music. The music, like, the first episode of Sirius the Jaeger, like, is just bam, it's like right in there, and the music just takes off, especially the use of violins in this series. It's so abrupt, fast-paced, especially during the action scenes, and it just really encompassed well with the fast action-paced scenes with the abrupt violin music. Oh my god, I was like in love. Like, I was in love every time the music started. And I should say the opening theme is beautiful. Like, the lyrics just describe about Yuli's internal struggle when you read them on the screen. And the main theme is done by the, oh god, I can't even say it, the something, Abiyoshi and the Rockets, which they've done the themes for Blossom Into Yesterday PA Works show, and they've also done Strike the Blood series as well, the opening themes. They're a very unique band, very catchy vocalists, female vocalists they have, and beautiful song, loved it. So animation and music is just absolutely top notch in this series to me. And in terms of, like, the story is very, I have to be honest, is generic. It's as what you think, vampire hunters going after vampires. It's very, you know, yeah, generic in that aspect. But obviously the focus is on Yuli and going from a path of revenge to finally being relieved of wanting to take a path of revenge is the real focus of the series. And you get to learn about Yuli a lot in this series, his backstory. It was kind of disappointing that you didn't get to learn about like the other other hunters, their backstory. But don't worry, I'm going to highlight on an important point related to that in a minute. But yeah, generic story was generic, and there was lack of backstory around the characters. But in terms of like the Japanese voice actors, I actually really loved the Japanese voicing in this series. Everybody's voices was like perfect, spot on. Yuli at first, it seems like this really standoffish, unlikable character. There's not much going for him for you to like, you know, grab onto him as the protagonist as it goes through this short series of 12 episodes. By the end of it, I loved Yuli. He's like, he's just, you know, just like this adorable wolf boy. Of course, the wolf aspect of him, I'm a little disappointed on. Like, I'm not gonna say any more. I'm not, but I was just a bit disappointed on. In terms of this series, actually, how it ended, this is gonna get a second season. Like, without a doubt, we're gonna get an announcement because of how it left off of. It's definitely clear as day that this is gonna get a second season, which I'm happy about. I am not watching a vampire series in a long time. This was still so good to actually get a vampire series this year because I feel there's been so much lacking in the vampire genre that there's been no new series. And you know what, even if, you know, I thought Sarah the Jaeger was like generic in some parts, you know, it's a hit or miss show. You're either gonna love it or you're not, but it was so refreshing to watch this year. You know what? Like, the animation, the music, the action is all spot on. Like, spot on. So, this series has equally hit or misses, but, you know, it's all up to your own interpretation, but it was definitely what I needed this year. I still would recommend Sirius the Jaeger. I still would to give it a chance. If you want to check out Sirius the Jaeger, it's definitely on Netflix now. Yes! By the time this video goes up. That is all I got for day 10 of the 12 days of anime. We're down to the last 2 days. So, what is the next one? So, what's the next hint gonna be, leader? Let me see. So, the next hint I'm gonna give you for day 11. Yes, I hope you're all having a merry, merry time. Hopefully you got all your Christmas shopping done and such at this time. But yeah, I will see all you guys tomorrow for day 11 of the 12 days of anime. Bye bye for now.